Hello everyone. In the last session, we discussed about tourism and its basic elements. Today, we'll talk about the impact of tourism. Talking about the impact of tourism, majorly, there are three types of impacts: economic impact, environmental impact, and socio-cultural impact. Today, we will talk about the economic impacts of tourism. Well, every coin, when flipped, has two sides, heads or tails. In the same way, every impact has two sides, positive and negative. The positive impacts of tourism covers income and employment, source of foreign exchange, developing infrastructure, the multiplier effect, regional development, economic value of cultural resources. The negative impacts of tourism includes creating sense of antipathy, increase in price, seasonal character of jobs, low remuneration, and import leakage. We'll look into the positive impacts of tourism one by one. Employment generation. In very simple words, more number of tourists that visit a country, the more number of people required to provide services to them. So it's directly proportional. Here's a glimpse of data. Tourism acts as an instrument of employment generation. Around 8.7% of total employment in India was generated by tourism. Similarly, due to employment generation, it contributes to the gross domestic product, which was equal to 6.7%. Earning foreign exchange. Tourism acts as a source of foreign exchange earning in India. For example, tourism was a $100 billion industry in 2008 and a $275.5 billion industry by 2018. Today, it might have been slowed down because of this pandemic, but it will definitely grow back again. Infrastructural development. Tourism encourages development of infrastructure. For example, transport. If you remember from the last session, accessibility was one of the important A's of the five A's of tourism. If a place is important in purview of tourism, the government is likely to develop transport so that people can reach there through road, air, or water. To build up land transport, they have to build up roads. For air, they may have to build up airports. And for coastal area, they may have to build up the ports. If more and more people are coming from outside, better healthcare facilities are required. And these healthcare facilities may even benefit the local people as well. Tourism multiplier effect. The money spent by the tourist passes through the various sections of economy. What does that mean? That means when a tourist spends some money to purchase service or product, it passes on to the grassroots level. That means, for example, if you purchase a bread, one portion of that money will definitely go to the farmer who is growing that wheat. Development at regional level. We just had a word about infrastructural development. In continuation of that, the areas which are underdeveloped but important in purview of tourism may get developed by infrastructural development, which we had just talked about, like roads, healthcare facilities development, and transport related facilities. Not only roads, but also the connectivity by bus, trains may be increased. Now, this will also benefit the local people. Economic development of cultural resources. Now, tourists who visit a particular country try to buy souvenirs which are indigenous in nature. That means those souvenirs which are made by the local people using their own local art and craft. So that develops the local art and craft. And because they are purchasing it directly from them, it affects the income of those artisans. Now we will discuss the negative impacts one by one. Creating sense of opposition. Now, tourism may also be less beneficial to the community of local businessmen. What does I mean by that? It means 80% of income that comes from the tourism goes to airlines, hotels and international companies that caters to these tourists. So there can be a development of antipathy in the local people about it. Increase in prices. Wherever the tourist goes, they will demand for good products and services. This increase in demand of tourist will result in the hike of price in case of goods and services. Now the tourists may be able to afford that. However, the income of the local people may not be increasing in the same proportion. So it may result in the same sense of antipathy that we have just discussed. Seasonal character of jobs. Tourism acts as a source of employment generation that we have already discussed. However, many jobs in the tourism industry are seasonal in nature. For example, jobs at a resort on a hill station. Now, because these jobs are seasonal in nature, so the resulted income is also unstable. In one season, which is a peak season, people will get jobs and get good income. In the other one, they may go even out of job. Low remuneration. Researchers nowadays are highlighting this point as a negative part of tourism. According to them, the pay and related benefit of tourism services is quite inadequate in the unorganized sector. However, there are researchers that indicates that the people who are working in the organized sector, like hotels, five-star hotels or luxurious hotels, also show discontent in terms of remuneration. Import leakage. Now, this is very important to discuss here. When the tourist demand for a standard product, food or drink, it is possible that the local industry is not able to meet their expectation or may not be able to generate that for them. So it has to be imported from outside. So when the things are imported, the local people are not benefited of them. So the income is considered to be leaked. These are the references. You can go through the references to study more about these things in detail. So that was about the economic impact of tourism in terms of positive impacts and negative impacts. As I said earlier, when a coin is flipped, it has got two sides. So all impacts, whether it is economic, environmental or socio-cultural, will have their positive as well as negative impacts. Thank you so much.